please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
There goes the bell, and it is indeed a 0.25% higher start, now 0.28, 0.3 higher. That's 11,420. Wouldn't that count as a new high for the index? The Bank Nifty is starting a little muted compared to the big boys. It's about 40 points higher, 0.15, 27,940. So the dip, if any, is coming in the Bank Nifty. At the moment, Nifty and Sensex opening fairly decent, a third of a percent higher at these elevated levels. And Hindalco is the star of the morning, and the Aleris shine is just rubbing on to this stock as well. 1.6 higher, Zee Entertainment, DRL, M&M results due today. Fresh 52-week high for that stock. Infosys, Hero Motocorp, all of them are starting almost a percent higher. HCL Tech, Hero, I mean, I could go on. Grasim, UPL, Tech Mahindra. Most of the tech stocks are reasonably up today, and that I think is because the rupee is reaching out to 69. What's not doing well? The Red Brigade are the corporate banks, actually. Maybe a little bit of profit is being taken away. So you have ICICI Bank, Axis Bank leading the Red Brigade. Adani Ports as well. People not quite impressed at all with the numbers. Cipla, the oil stocks are also slightly seeing profit taking. Not much. HPBP and IOC. Bharti Airtel Power Grid also added to the Red Brigade. It's a small Red Brigade, but largely corporate banks. And that's why important to note. But the mid caps, it's a 0.25% rise at the index level.
Well, it is. But the stocks really to look at right now are the Adani Group stocks. Adani Power is down 10%, and huge volumes on Adani Power. Adani Ports is also down about 1%. But Adani Power, look at that. It's an 850 crore loss that the company has posted this time around. And that's something that's not gone down well with the street at all. In fact, PLFs have fallen quite a bit. Coal unavailability is the issue. So that's the space to look at. Syndicate Bank is down about 3.5%. Ujjivan is down about 2% post the numbers. Not looking good. In fact, across the board, financials are under pressure. So, even in the broader market, something like an IDBI bank, etc., are under pressure. Motherson Sumi, ahead of its numbers today, is down almost about 0.5%. So, keep an eye out on that. On the upside, you have Parag Milk. That's up 7.5%, post a good set of numbers. LIC Housing Finance, in fact, the entire NBFC space is looking good, up almost about 2-3% over there. And a couple of other stocks, perhaps you'd want to look at. Avanti Feeds, post numbers. In pre-opening, Avanti Feeds was under quite a bit of pressure. It's now down almost 9%. EBITDA has halved. It's, numbers not looking good at all. Dixon Tech is also down almost about 4% over there. So looking a pretty disappointing there. Now, the Bank Nifty is under pressure. It's in the red, in fact.
Sorry. No, I was just going to say Dhanlakshmi, Syndicate, Ujjivan, all the bank and non-banks that came with numbers after market hours are getting pummeled. But Aruj, today the Nifty Bank is giving the dip.
Yeah, today it is giving the dip. I think the
Nifty as well.
Yeah, Nifty as well. So let's see how things move from here. 30 points down is what we have. I think Adani Group, Sonia has already discussed. Ujjivan is interesting. Syndicate Bank is actually recovering from the low point, but still down about 2-2.5%. Ashwani, your thoughts on market opening and any interesting trading idea?
See, today's Bank Nifty decline is because of all this overexcitement yesterday. So I wouldn't be surprised if you get into that zone of 11,380, 400. Similarly, Bank Nifty gets back towards this 27, 850, 900. So at some point, the dip will be bought. But I think this could be a more significant dip than one you would buy immediately at the open. I would think giving back 100, 150 may not hurt the Bank Nifty too much. So still good time to get into intraday shorts. And Bank Nifty as well could lose another 20, 25 points from here.
Ooh, intraday shorts, is it first before you buy the dip? That's interesting. What about you, Sudarshan? Anything that you have found interesting now? What about the corporate banks in particular, Axis, SBI, ICICI?
Oh, no, I completely avoid the corporate banks. I have already told you, Yes Bank and State Bank. But the Nifty is not a buy now. I suggested 11,370 as the point at which we would start to look to buy. That's the cash index. So okay. I'll be patient. If it doesn't come there, there is no buying. Sun Pharma is a buying opportunity, and so is Gale. Both can be considered.
Okay, but just pull out the chart of Ashok Leyland. I think the news which is there is that the government has reduced the maximum safe axle weight to 7 tons. From 7.5 tons per single XL. So there's been a bit of a norm change. We don't know, you know, how it's going to impact, companies, but the stock
less
is
overloading than originally thought.
You know, I did check with a few analysts when this came out. They said that they were factoring in retrospective for existing vehicles, and it's just that notification has come now.
Okay.
So this was really on expected lines. So that's there's no major change from what they were expecting earlier.
Okay,
so
further back.
No major change. All right, fair enough. Mitesh, your thoughts on market opening?
So subdued opening, and I expect some kind of a subdued day. We had had a 30-40 point kind of start, but then it's immediately dipped. I think we might be quiet till the noon time. But some stocks are on the radar. I think Oil India is kind of trying to break on the upside. M&M, once it starts getting past 945, 946, should be a breakout. And TVS Motor, after a good decline, is now showing signs of reversals on the intraday chart.
Okay. Ashwini, do you look at us Parag Milk at all? It's up 8% after the numbers.
See, these are all, mid-cap stocks which got bashed up. So, I would think, as a portfolio, it's a good stock, but is the milk doing very well? I don't think so. Mm-hmm. A gap up, and possibly if you get follow-through, 365, 370, but overall, not too exciting.
Okay, and Ashwini, what's your big call for the day?
See, big call is that today, it looks like financials want to do some profit booking. So the first call here is to get short on Bank Nifty. And once we get closer to say 27, 750, 800 on the futures, that would be a good time to consider long positions. But I think last couple of days have been way too heady, and 100, 150 points on the downside shouldn't be a surprise.
All right, gentlemen, thanks a lot for taking us through market opening. Of course, we'll come back to you around 10 a.m. For now, let's invite our market master for the day, Kenneth Andrade, founder and CEO of Old Bridge Capital Management, is with us. Kenneth, good morning. The last 2 weeks, the screen has been better. The portfolios have got repaired a bit after the kind of brutal fall that we saw in mid-caps and small-caps. You reckon the worst of the pain is over in the broader market?
Well, valuations came to an interesting level, and I think the follow-up on valuations were basically the quarterly numbers, which are also much better than most of the expectations that were there. So I think the culmination of these two, I think the worst is already done in this space.
Okay, the worst in terms of stock price reduction is over, is what you're saying?
I guess the correction that happened in the last couple of months came through after this part of the market did something extraordinary in 2017. Okay, and if you see the deviation of the mid cap index and the small cap index versus the large cap index in 2017, it was at least 30% higher than the large cap indices. Some part of that correction was very warranted, and you had it coming in this. Now it could be a question of it could be a technical reason why they corrected. The initiation of all of this came because of a couple of rules or a couple of companies actually deviating from the mean in terms of both corporate governance, accounting standards, etc. So all of that came to naught in 2018. What's happened in the last one quarter, which was the June quarter, which is expectedly the weakest quarter of the entire year because it's the starting of the financial year, results were much better than expected. Even on a sequential basis, and March quarter is always the best quarter for the financial year. So June quarter was even better than some of the results were even better than the previous quarter. So I think that should hold up a significant basket of companies that are there going into this financial year.
Okay. One of your big positive bets or bets that paid very well were the rural stocks. We were just discussing with another expert as well, rural and consumer stocks. Would you persist, or at least consumption stocks, do you think have priced in all there is to price?
So markets are obviously being transitionary, and it has to be going into the next couple of and it's always going to be transitioning into the next cycle. So while we keep a watch on valuations, I mean, some companies, some good companies are available at cheap valuations, and some segments of the market might get expensive for periods of time. I think that's where we take a pause and relook at the entire environment and just move on into probably another space that looks interesting for us. So yes, that part of the environment did reasonably well going into 2018 and 2019. Mm-hmm. There have been some steep price corrections also in that space, so I can't say that everything did went as per plan. There have been some steep price corrections. But from both the balance sheet matrix and as far as the earning matrix, a lot of these companies still hold on. So so as we transition going forward, I think we're looking at pockets of opportunity which are cheap and which are which have reasonable amount of growth, and we'll try to pick businesses in that space.
Okay. You know, the other space, Kenneth, that you have followed actively and you've been interested in is the media space. But we've seen so many changes there. It's really dynamic with digitization, etc. And there's a lot of consolidation as well. How do you approach this space now? Does it look as attractive now than it did about, say, a year ago?
So the number of companies that look attractive now are fewer than that they were in the last part of the cycle, which is about 2 years back, and that breadth is narrowing down to a couple of them that are there on the ground. There's intense amount of pricing pressure on the ground. I agree with that part of it all, and that helps the industry consolidate itself. So our sense is that we probably were a little early, or we probably were a little early into the cycle, and consolidation will play its way into the next year or two before spending comes back into the environment. So two things have happened. One is spending has not come back into the environment, and whatever incremental amount of spending that has been there on advertising has gone into the digital space. The traditional formats haven't been able to get market share in that, and you can see that with what's happening in the print business. Mm-hmm. You've seen some of that also come out into the electronic into the electronic media space. So our sense is you've got few properties that advertisers want to spend on. You've got spending that might just about start coming into the cycle, and we've seen that in pockets that are happening. So it just might stretch itself over the next couple of quarters or years probably.
Okay. By the way, steel stocks are really surging right now. Tata Steel making high point right now. A couple of others also. Kenneth, you know, you've studied so many of these cycles. Your thoughts on metals in particular, because we've seen stocks correct quite a bit after a two-year bull market. Do you reckon we are still in the middle of a cycle and it's still good time to add some metals to portfolio?
The metal space in India is behaving reasonably different from what's happening across the world. There is reasonable amount of stress. So let's put it this way. Overcapacity is not out of the cycle yet, and that's globally. In India, overcapacity is out of the cycle, and a large part of this industry has also been helped because of the tariffs that have been imposed on the entire system. So it's a cycle of profitability which is probably very different from what's happening internationally. So we'll have to just wait and watch. It's not really a capitalist environment as far as that part of the industry is. And if it's not so, then this industry probably deserves to trade at a much lower valuation, because it's basically not free trade. So my sense is that I'll wait, watch. We're definitely mid-cycle way through that commodity space. I wouldn't be in a tearing hurry to add too many companies out there.
Okay, what about the finance space, Kenneth?
Okay, so you know, you have identified a couple of themes earlier that played out very well, whether it's the consumption theme, the rural theme, even media. Any other themes that look interesting from a long-term investor standpoint?
I think, I said this before, part of the entire cycle that you will see emerging is the deleveraged corporate balance sheets that are there. And that's significantly happening as far as all manufacturing in India is concerned, and also goes into the commodity space. So as we go to 2021, and probably a little bit of 2022, we'll see the exhaustion of these capacities on the ground, and then probably you'll see a fresh capex revival in the entire segment of the market. And that goes for anything that has got to do with manufacturing, anything that's got to do with utilities, power generation, and even to an extent some of the basic industrial products that are there, which is the metal space that is there. So if we've been able to optimize capacity and get reasonable amount of pricing going into 2020, I think that's the big part of the market that will play out. And all of this is actually on the asset side of the balance sheet that is there in corporate India. So you got deleveraged balance sheets, you got increased capacity utilization or increased PLFs as far as utilities are concerned. And if you've been able to optimize some of that, and we've seen a large part of that happen, and we're not really predicting big growth numbers coming in. Even if we average a 6% GDP growth that is there on the ground, I think that's a very high number for where the capex cycle in India is currently. We will exhaust all of this into 2020. And that will be a very interesting year to see how profitability spikes at that point in time. So various analysts have various numbers to it all, but I think this utilization of capacity will actually spike profitability of corporate India back to its traditional levels, which is about 4% of GDP. If that happens, I really don't think markets are really stretched as far as valuations are concerned.
Okay. Kenneth, one last question from my side then. This is a big election year, and of course next year we have the general election as well. In the past, we've seen, sometimes the markets, for right or wrong, do take politics as a big factor. Of course, in hindsight, sometimes that proves to be the best buying opportunity. But the question I'm asking is, from here till the general elections, is there going to be a bit of pressure on the market from the political uncertainty?
Well, you will always get volatility into large events, and this is a predictable large event, as in it's an event that will happen. What are the outcomes? I think market will react post that. And I think as you've seen politics evolve in India, we've grown through the cycle of volatility that has been there, and we've come out much better. Going into this cycle, I think what you need to realize also is that, like I said, corporate solvency is not really a question mark here. And if corporate solvency is not a question mark, I think the cycle will be delayed if there's an unfavorable election result. Okay, but the cycle will be delayed. So that's the only thing that we have to look forward to. I mean, will it happen in 2019, 2020, or 2021? But I think if you put it all together, the balance sheets are in place to take advantage of whatever growth this economy can deliver. If they can deliver, you could see the results happening next year, or would probably get it delayed by another 1 year.
Okay. All right, Kenneth, thank you for joining us. We'll have to leave it at that. Well, that's the word coming in from Kenneth and Reddy. The market, by the way, is flat, but the Bank Nifty is now under a bit of pressure. There's some profit taking that you're seeing there, so don't lose sight of that. Top of mind is ICICI Bank. That's down about 1-odd%, followed by Axis Bank. We'll take a short break on that note. On the other side, reactions, earnings reactions lined up. Itira Davis.